what's the story behind this record, and you know, how long had you kind of had this in the planning for this album?
So, you know, I feel like I was kind of plucked off of it for Legends Never Die. And, you know, I probably said some things about it I probably shouldn't have, but you know, it is what it is. Mm-hmm. That it was the OG version, and Juice wanted the beat the way that we put it out, you know, this last time. And I think, you know, it's one thing to add some stuff for streams. It's one, you know, add an artist for some streams or like change the beat for radio or something like that. But, you know, when it comes to somebody's discography, I just felt like it was important to kind of preserve what it was that he knew it to be, and kind of take it back to that original thing. And whether you like it better with the beat or not, you know, for me, I knew the song as an acoustic sonic sounding thing. And when you add a beat to it, and you know, some Lex Luger, like 808s and
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Some drum kits. It's like, to me, it was just, it wasn't a good choice. You know, if that's the way he wanted it, he should have left it that way. And we kind of just, it was a big fight for this record to get it out. It's not easy to clear a song, especially nowadays with Juice, and it's not easy to clear a song with any artist, period. But, you know, with Juice, it was a fight to get this record out. So it really meant a lot to me. And you know, from a lot of different standpoints to get this record out and it do what it did, you know?